All right, what is going on? So we are back with the Akai S950 rack mount sampler. And today we're going to pair it up with the ultimate combination that this is known for, that everyone kind of was introduced to the S950 at some point with, the EMU SP-1200. Now, before we do that, just in case you don't know, we have just released the Akai S950 Operational Manual. If you have this sampler, if you're thinking about getting this sampler, if you realize how much of a staple a sampler like this is to have, this is the manual for you. It's designed to get you through the ins and outs and the whys of this sampler. Like, there's things that this sampler is known for, mainly the filter, you know, the time stretch, things like that. But even I overlooked the subtleties that it has in actually being a robust instrument. Like, you can do a lot with it. And today we're going to pair it up traditionally with the SP-1200 and see what we can come with. In addition, there's so much news. Episode 37 of the Samplers podcast is live. When you have a moment, check it out. Now on to the EMU SP-1200. Classic pairing with the S950. Today we got kind of the drums and sort of miscellaneous stuff coming from the SP-1200 and sort of other loops and stuff coming from the S950. Now the interesting thing about this is, yes, it's difficult to get one of these for a decent price, but if you are one of those who are looking forward to the new SP-2400, you can get a good gauge of what things will sound like with this pairing. So today we're just going to run a quick sequence and listen to what things sound like. It's a classic combination for a reason. And traditionally, just so you know, the limitations of each kind of balance each other out. Like the S950 has 8-note polyphony with a good bit of sample time. The SP-1200 has about 2 seconds on each pad for drums. So it's kind of difficult to make a worthwhile song on this. You can do it. It's definitely not impossible to do and it's not that hard to do. But if you want more, that's what the S950's role was. So the classic pairing of these two kind of covered all the bases, which is why you've seen the two of them together most of the times and not just one or the other. Especially since the S950 is a rack, it kind of needs something to control it with. And in this case, that's what the SP-1200 is doing. All right, let's listen to what's going on. And that is it. Classic combination. You can really see, like, it's a mixture of the sounds of the two. Like, this is pretty crunchy. Like, it's really, really crunchy. And if we go down to the S950 sounds, it's, right? It's really kind of warm and a lot heavier, like a lot more body on the S950. So the pairing of the two really, really defines an era and really has, like, Well, it's hard to say because it's a balance that we're used to. Like, we're used to hearing these two play together, but no doubt it's a really, really nice combination. They really, really play well together. Anyway, that is all I wanted to show you guys today. Thanks for hanging out. In the meantime, please do take care of yourself. Peace.